Mamma Mia. Now I really know. My, my, I should not have let you go. Hello, everyone. We're so sad that we're not there this year performing at West End Live alongside all the other shows. But thankfully, to Sky and to Salt, they found a way of bringing you this unique virtual performance.
Sophie in Mamma Mia, and I have got all of your questions here. I think maybe in general, maybe like Voulez-vous, because we're all, although actually that is quite hard to sing because we're all doing like full on dancing. Maybe to sing, maybe like Mamma Mia, the actual song Mamma Mia, because everyone's doing kind of like the heads through the door and there's like people off stage singing and stuff. And yeah, that's, it's always nice to sing kind of maybe differently to what is usual, just like standing on stage and singing. But yeah, Voulez-vous is quite hard because there's lots of dancing, and Mamma Mia is lots of kind of like head situations like this and singing like that.
I would say Voulez-vous because it's the big number at the end of act one. And we're all together on stage having a fabulous time, or not, dancing together, and we're all about to get a cup of tea at the interval. But it's such a rousing, big ensemble number that that's probably the most fun.
I would say the cast have the most enjoyment singing, the hymn in just before the wedding, because I think it's the one song that we rehearse the most, so we get the most enjoyment when we do it right. And we see our little musical director do like this, and we do it right. That gives us huge joy.
I reckon the song in the finale, definitely, because that's when everyone's, the whole cast is on the stage. And it really, it's a really good feel good. It gets all the audience up, and it's, they're really good feel good songs. So I think that kind of sums up what Mamma Mia is about.
I think literally ever since I was a kid, actually, like eight, maybe like seven or eight, I did some open auditions and ended up playing the role of Annie in the UK tour. And just, I've literally never thought of anything else, really.
I first realised I could. It was a possibility to even do it, because I had no concert, I had no actors in the family or anything like that. But I remember being age of 12-ish on the front row of the theatre, my local theatre, Theatre Clwyd in Mould, because I'm from North Wales, seeing a production of Three Men in a Boat and being almost able to touch these guys who were just normal human beings doing this for a living. And I thought then, oh, maybe I could do that.
This changes all the time. I'm actually a massive ABBA fan, like a big fan, listen to them a lot in my spare time. Best ABBA song at the minute, I love a song called I've Been Waiting For You, which actually I believe is in the second film. But yeah, I love that song.
Got to be Winner Takes It All. I've got a feeling that's going to be an answer to quite a few of these.
Probably Gimme Gimme. Don't ask me why. I don't need a man after midnight, but I've always listened to that song from a young age, so I think it's that one, yeah.
They're all brilliant. I tell you one, the my favourite one that isn't in the show is The Day Before You Came. I wish that was in the show, because I love that show, that song. So I'll go for that one. Must be funny
in a rich man's world. Well, obviously, because I was watching Meryl Streep do Donna. I mean, you can't get better than that, can you?
I tried not to watch the film, actually, when I first started the job back on the tour in, I think I started in like 2016, a long time ago. And I'd watched the film, I think when it first came out, I went to see it at the cinema, but then I didn't watch it again because I kind of wanted to make it my own. And that's the brilliant thing about Mamma Mia, they kind of let you just put your own personality into every part.
Personally, no, I'd never seen the film, and when I knew I was going to be doing this job, I deliberately didn't go and watch it. Some people like to watch other people do the part, others don't. I preferred to try and find Sam, who Sam is, for myself without seeing Pierce do it. Of course, I've seen him since and he's great.
Songs, not at all, because I knew them all already, because massive ABBA fan. ABBA Gold on the Walkman when I was a kid, knew every word, took about 2 minutes. Dance routines, however, potentially not my main forte, let's put it that way. Thankfully, Sophie doesn't do like loads and loads of dancing, but I'm gonna say yes to that question. It did take me a long time to learn the dances. All the amazing dancers in the ensemble, no time at all. They pick it up in the kind of like, I think our rehearsal process is what, like 3 weeks, 4 weeks, something like that. So yeah, they pick it up super quickly. They're absolutely amazing. I, on the other hand, still to this day, 4 years later, I've been doing the show, still doubt myself in the finale sometimes. So yeah, one, really quick, the other, not so quick.
Leah Sue, our choreographer, is going to love this one. I don't think it takes long to learn them. I think it takes long to do them correctly.
Yes, certainly longer for some than others. I'd say I still don't know them all properly now, so I'd say it probably takes about eight to nine months to learn the songs and dances, yeah.
Yes, I did. Love ABBA.
Yes, I did. I loved ABBA music. I used to have a Walkman with headphones, and I used to have a swing at the back of my garden when I was really little, and I had ABBA's Greatest Hits, and that's what I play on my headphones.
Yes, how could you not? It's part of our cultural DNA. I wasn't particularly a brilliant fan, but when I started to learn them, I realised that I knew them, most of them already.
ABBA was always played on the radio, and my mum and dad played it all the time. They deliver some bangers.
Super trooper, beams are gonna blind me.
But... no, we don't, but they look amazing, and they've been designed. They do actually kind of get maybe slightly altered for each person, and we do have our own costumes made for us every single time someone new plays the role, and all the understudies as well get their own costumes made for them. So the wedding dress, for example, I have kind of slightly different sleeves to some of the other times that the wedding dress has been worn. There's like other certain things. People will have maybe slightly different shorts because it suits their body shape a little bit better. Yeah, stuff like that. So it does kind of get tailored to perfection to all of us. But yeah, we can't really go like, I really like that, can I wear that? Although I do, I felt myself like merge into Sophie because I've played the role for so long. I find myself wearing turquoise basically just like all the time. So yeah, we don't really get to say what the costumes look like. However, I do base my own personal wardrobe on the show.
No, not remotely. They are all set down in the Bible, and Sam wears the black linen, whether he's in Manila, Sydney, or the West End. So it's all very, very carefully worked out by much cleverer people than me. Although, I will say our marvellous, beautiful wardrobe mistress, Ruth McCorkindale, does give us a say on the shoes to an extent, because shoes are sort of a very individual and essential part of your performance, because if you've got the wrong shoes on, you're in trouble. So yes, we get a certain amount of say in our shoes. But other than that, no. Why would you want to change it?
They tell us what we're wearing. And we can say if we like it, but it won't make any difference. But thankfully for me, I love mine. I mean, how can you not?
I think maybe the 20th anniversary, that was the most incredible night. And I think because I'd been a part of the show already for 3 years at that point, and I'd just gone into the West End with the show as well. So it was really special time. I'd only been in the West End for about a month.
Tell you one thing, there's a thing we do occasionally, usually once a year, lots of shows do these, called relaxed performances. And a relaxed performance is a performance especially for people with special needs, learning disabilities, autistic kids, generally people who might not be able to go to the theatre without it being a lot of hassle and trouble. And so we have an audience full of people who are just so happy to be there, and doing that show, I remember being massively taken aback when we did that for the first time, because there's a lot of noise, obviously, there's people shouting out, enjoying it, and getting feedback all the time, but seeing the parents of these kids being out and it being okay, not being worried that their child was maybe being inappropriate or making a noise, and not having to be embarrassed or worry about it, and just having a marvellous time. Doing a show for those people, there were 30 people on that stage in floods of tears for that curtain call. That was a special night.
My favourite memory was the 20th anniversary show, when they got all previous cast members together, alongside Bjorn and Benny and Judy and all the creatives, and it was just epic. It was amazing.
Thank you for the music.
the songs I'm singing.
Go and say hello to the dads, actually, that is a ritual. I go and say hello to the dads every night before every show. I always knock on their door and go, hello daddies! Because they are just below, they are downstairs. So as I'm going to the stage, I might as well go say hey, so I pass them anyway. Say I always do that.
I feel extremely strongly about having perfume on before I go on stage. Weird. I do that. And if I haven't put it on, I'm like, oh no! I don't know why.
We try and push it as late as possible to get ready for all having cups of tea and eating our lunch and having our showers probably about 5 minutes before we're supposed to go on. I shouldn't probably be telling you that, but I think we do it every day and it's worked up until now, so I think that's a bit of our good luck ritual.
I just put this baby on every day and see if I'm allowed another chip, basically. If I can't breathe, no.
Well, vocally, it is quite a worry, actually, because I haven't had more than 2 weeks off stage for 8 years that I've been doing the show. And so suddenly to have months and months and months of not singing for 4 hours solid every night and not running around and jumping up and down, there is a certain amount of horror at the idea of having to go back and being fat, blobby, and not being able to sing. So I don't know if you saw, we posted the beautiful Marcus Savage, our musical director, posted his patented Mamma Mia vocal warm-up on YouTube the other day, which is brilliant, which is the warm-up that we do before the show every night. But now we've got it on video, and I do that twice a day. I do that in the early afternoon, just after my lunch, and then again in the early evening, just after my dinner. I have a good old saying, I tend to shut myself in the garage so that I don't drive my family crazy. And so I'm there in all the sawdust amongst all the tools and bags of rubbish, singing my head off. So I do that a lot. And I'm trying to do as much exercise as I possibly can, running around with my kids and playing a lot of table tennis and trying to stay fit.
Thank you for all your questions. Stay fit, stay well, and stay safe. And hopefully we'll see you soon. Cheers.
Thanks, love you all. See you soon.
I'm very sad not to be at West End Live this year, but we'll see you there brighter and happier and healthier than ever next year.
So from all of us at Mamma Mia, stay safe, be well, and we'll see you soon. I'm going to be late for this. Bye now.